Well, I'm told that we are also joined in by Mr. YS Rajan, who's a scientist and an honorary distinguished professor in the Indian Space Research Organization. He's joining us from Bengaluru. Mr. Rajan, thank you very much indeed, sir, for taking time out and you know, joining us on this broadcast in Wion. You know, let me begin by asking you this. We saw some very tense moments unfold there at the ISRO headquarters. You know, give us a sense of what is actually playing out. You know, as the scientists, we saw at this point of time, the status is that the communication between the Vikram lander and the headquarters in ISRO, that has broken down. What are we to make of this?
See, I was also sitting and watching beyond all through, almost from 12:30 onwards, looking for the event. And it was initially very, very happy that that trajectory and the predicted trajectory were going on very well. That is the one in the red to green. And the bound was there. It is well, very good. Then in the last point, when there is a small deviation which took place, I was wondering what it was doing. And now I think a lot of experts have told before, I was hearing the beyond, they have explained everything. For me to make one more speculation will not be good. It is a tense.
Right.
But it is not strictly, I am now talking scientifically, is that scientifically, technologically, is that it is not a time to write off saying that it is gone.
Absolutely. That is
at the same time, we can hope that orbiter picks up. Orbiter will pick up. If it picks up, then good. Or orbiter may pick up, not a signal, but maybe something, some bodies around, something it has gone down. All these possibilities are there. For and ISRO teams would have looked at many of these scenarios. And as somebody else was saying, nobody is there to take a picture there.
Indeed.
Nobody is there to come on, guide it. So it has to do all by itself. So let us hope. Actually, I was happy that Prime Minister Pat has shiven so well and made all of them to feel relaxed and also supported it, saying that don't worry, what you have achieved, even up to that stage, is not an ordinary thing. It is an immense job, assuming that everything is okay, it crashed or whatever it is. Even then, it is an immense job, because in space, it is not very easy. One should remember that out of the lunar missions, if I remember approximately, about 37% is only the success rate. I hope that this will recover. Now I say hope. This is not, I am not telling it from any backup of a data or something. As an individual, as an Indian, and also as a person who had been with ISRO, Vikram Sarabhai time frame 1964, so I would hope that something will turn up. Absolutely. It will say some signal is there. Oh God, that fellow is gave a signal. But we don't have much precedence because the number of lunar missions are low. But such loss of signal and coming back signal takes place in other satellites. Sometimes it goes off. But here we don't know. So best thing is leave it to the team. And ISRO's chairman statement was very measured. They told at 2.7 kilometers we lost signal. When you don't have signal, when a diagnosis is not there, doctor cannot say the thing is not there, doctor cannot say what happened. So it is that type of thing. So they will be doing, they will be working very hard to find out all other possibilities, looking the signal through some other stations which will be visible. That's the type of thing. It is in a small place in moon. It's not easy. It's not easy. But they will do. Finally, they will come to a conclusion in maybe after some few more minutes or a few more hours or few more days. They will definitely tell what has happened, because looking at any anomaly analysis, even if it was successful, if there are some things did not behave the way it should have been, that is called anomaly. Even that is analyzed by ISRO. It doesn't leave it. And it is so with all space agencies, because you have to know why Even though it was successful, why it happened? Absolutely. Naturally, in such a situation, they will do a complete analysis and go ahead. Because that has been the thing of ISRO right from the beginning. We will do.
Absolutely, indeed. Mr. Rajan,
we will make it. And if not now, next time. And if it comes now, mm-hmm. we are very happy.
You know, I want to ask you a slightly a technical question in terms of what is happening, because what we know for sure is that there has been a communication breakdown. Everything else is purely in the realm of speculation. Now, the manner in which this entire probe is carried out is not through instructions that are fed from the headquarters in Bengaluru, but by already the information that is present and fed into these probe machines, which are only now executing this mission. So my question to you is, even though there is a communication breakdown between the Vikram lander, will the rest of the probe continue as normal? Is that how it is designed?
See, it depends. It's a good question. See, it was coming like this. Then it started when they said that it is that the terror starts, where it makes a very fast descent, fast mm-hmm. braking, mm-hmm. then coming to the slow one. The retro rocket is, it will fire in the same direction as the lander. Same direction as the lander, so that it doesn't make it fast. So it will be working against it. So slowly it has to come down. Mm-hmm. Possibilities are infinite. One is just a mere some problem with the communication. Mm-hmm. But otherwise it can land well and it will be doing its work.
All right.
It will be doing its work, but it will keep sending the data also, but there may not be a signal. So that is one scenario. Another one is maybe something has happened, some little topple, it just went tuck, some toppled somewhere. Uh-huh. There's a possibility. But what it is difficult. Between these two ranges, anything is possible. So there is a finite possibility mm-hmm. that it could have landed, maybe with some difficulty might have landed, may still then start doing the work.
That
because
is
the batteries are there. What you require is power, battery, and all the data systems. So it can work.
All right.
There is a finite possibility.
All right.
Other this thing is some part might have been little malfunctioning is a thing. But whether we get a signal, mm-hmm. what is important is it has to talk to us. So let us wait till the orbiter sees it. If orbiter picks up a signal, then it will know. And orbiter also has got powerful cameras in it. That is going round. That is a mothership which has put it. That is called, whole thing is called Chandrayaan. It has put it down. Mm-hmm. Now it will see how the Vikram is behaving. It will see it, will get the data. So that is a good possibility. And then also somewhere, ISTRAC also, the ISTRAC, what is ISRO tracking station, mm-hmm. it will also be trying to look for signal. So other way to speak, yes, your answer to your question is, yes, there is a finite possibility that even if the signals were lost, the fellow could be doing its work, going around.
Right.
Going around and taking out, going around, this can't go around, it will stay put. Uh-huh. And then doing it. Anyway, there is a lot of dust also will be there. Mm-hmm. All that will be going on. And the rover anyway has to be released only after four days. Suppose it works, everything is fine.
Right.
Then the rover will work only after 4 days. So there is no problem with the rover. It is on the top, Pragyan. Only the Vikram, what it is doing, whether it has not crashed,
right.
whether it has not tilted, etc. One should not speculate now.
Absolutely.
It has to, only for the signal when it comes, then ISRO will put out a, and ISRO has been an open organization, it mm-hmm. will tell what has happened.
Indeed, that is true. I mean, because the statement that we heard from the ISRO chairman, that was very measured, and he said that at this point of time, ISRO is analyzing the data. Meanwhile, the Indian Prime Minister has, of course, put out this tweet where he has said that India is proud of our scientists. They've given their best and have always made India proud. These are moments to be courageous, and courageous we will be. This is what Prime Minister Modi has stated. And Professor Rajan, if I can come back to you for one more question, you know, what I would like to know is, in events like this, you know, the data will be analyzed by the scientists. Now, all of the instructions are already pre-fed into these three parts of the mission. Is there something which any of these scientists can do from the headquarters, or it has flown out from the Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota? Once that happens, do the scientists have no further say in any of these missions? In the
see, it's not that every little item they know how exactly it comes, but there are uncertainties which will be simulated. Mm-hmm. That simulation, they will give that options to those. There is a little bit of an onboard intelligence and memory and intelligence.
Right.
That is what with which it works. Even now, where you saw that breaking thing, command has been given. That the person was saying the number has been fed.
Right.
So the data which was coming about the location, they have done the optimum calculation. They have put okay, go to this position.
Mm-hmm.
That once that is told, it is just like putting in the Google map. You know that go to this place. So that much memory and this one, it takes place there.
Absolutely.
So that is what it is doing. So now it will not be developed. When you use the word analyzed in headquarters, this is not something like on the top chairman, etc., will be doing.
Right.
There will be various levels in which they will be looking at. Of course, chairman and other people will be intensely be with them. Just as PM was encouraging them,
uh-huh.
He will be encouraging them. Don't worry, let us look at it.
Indeed.
As I have said before, if there is a problem found, okay, it is due to some mistake in design, it won't be in this. So
right.
They will take it as such. But it takes time. One should not come to a, they will not rush to a conclusion.
Absolutely.
Because there is an opposite, other possibilities are existing.
Absolutely, indeed. They would not rush to a conclusion. Mr. Srivastav, you wanted to comment on this.
Yeah, so as you can see on the screen, there was a deviation in the trajectory in the last 2.1 kilometers, right?
Uh-huh.
And also it is understood from the data that is available to us that the rate of descent was very high compared to the rate of descent that was supposed to be there.
Mm-hmm.
So there is an anomaly there,
okay,
which clearly points to maybe, you know, malfunction of the engines or something has happened. Now, what I'm trying to say here is this, that there are two possibilities. One is this, that it has not been able to land properly,
mm-hmm.
but we still have rover inside.
That's true.
It is possible that the rover may be able to come out if it is really not very badly placed, and it could function. That's one possibility.
There's also this possibility that it has landed as normal.
And
everything is presently being played out
absolutely,
as normal.
Absolutely.
And the only thing that is not happening is the communication
link
the Vikram lander and the headquarters back home at ISRO.
And there's one very, Professor Rajan may agree with me. Orbiter is supposed to do more than 90% of the work.
Mm-hmm.
Orbiter has a life of more than 1 year. So maximum experiments which are supposed to be done are supposed to be done with the orbiter. We have not lost anything or everything, you know. Even in the worst case scenario, orbiter will continue to be in the orbit. It will continue to do the experiments, give us very valuable data which we can use for our future lunar missions. And also, if the lander has landed and it is not communicating, or it has landed a little bit, mm-hmm. Not in the ideal situation,
right,
not as per the coordinates that were fed to it, the rover could still function.
That's true. This is, of course, this point of time, this is the deviation that we're looking at on the map.
Yes.
The red and the green line. Everything was going pretty much on the dot till the final 2.1 kilometer altitude. It is from there on that we saw a bit of deviation. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who was, of course, watching the events unfold very closely from the ISRO headquarters, post the communication broke down, also spoke with the scientists. Let's listen in to what the Indian Prime Minister had to say.
देखिए जीवन में उतार चढ़ाव आते रहते हैं और जब मैं देख रहा था कि अब कम्युनिकेशन ऑफ हो गया है मैं देख रहा था आपके सारे चेहरे एकदम से हो गए, लेकिन कोई छूट आया भी, और जैसा मुझे बताया सब साइंटिस्टों ने कि अगर फिर से कम्युनिकेशन शुरू हुआ तो फिर तो बहुत सारी चीजें हमें देता रहे, तो होप फॉर द बेस्ट। लेकिन मेरी तरफ से आपको बहुत बधाई है, बहुत उत्तम सेवा की है आपने देश ने, आपने बहुत बड़ी सेवा की है विज्ञान की, और आपने बहुत बड़ी सेवा की है मानव जात की। इस पड़ाव से भी हम बहुत कुछ सीख रहे हैं, आगे भी हमारी यात्रा जारी रहेगी और मैं पूरी तरह आपके साथ हूं, हिम्मत के साथ चले। और आप ही के पुरुषार्थ से फिर से देश खुशी मनाने लग जाएगा, मुझे विश्वास है। Wish you all the best. Thank you.
All right, so that was India's Prime Minister there, wishing all the very best to the scientists, because let's reiterate the fact that, you know, at this point of time, what we know for a fact is that there has been a communication breakdown. It is perfectly possible that this communication link could be picked up again in a few next few minutes. This is something that does happen. It has happened in the past, and it's perfectly possible that stuff could be playing out as normal on the lunar surface. That of course is the best case scenario. Now there are a whole different varieties of scenarios that one could speculate upon, but at this point of time the information of course is with the ISRO scientists, and we expect that ISRO will be making a statement sometime soon.